Hello friends, in this video we will be looking at the last part of high-pass circuit, the wave shaping part. So let us start with the response of ramp input to the high-pass circuit, how the ramp signal will be modified or altered by using high-pass circuit. So let us start with first of all defining the high-pass or defining the ramp signal. So ramp signal is nothing but it is a signal which can be represented like this, which linearly increases with respect to time. This is time, this is Vi of t, and let us say the slope of this curve is alpha, and the input therefore it is going to be alpha t. The input is going to be alpha t. So we can say that this is the signal. Mathematically I can define the signal as, it is a signal whose amplitude Vi of t is equal to 0 for t less than 0, and which assumes the linear value alpha t for t greater than 0. So for t less than 0, it will, of course, the value will be 0 for the ramp signal, and for the t greater than 0 time sequence or time period, the input will be linearly increasing. Maybe we can call it as alpha t, where alpha is the slope of this particular curve. Okay. Now this waveform is applied to the high pass circuit that we have already seen now. So this is the diagram for high pass circuit. Here I will be getting the V0 output. Here we will be applying the V in input, and this is RC circuit, which is acting as high pass circuit. So I can say it is high pass circuit. And what is this? This is a ramp signal. So when this ramp signal is applied to the high pass circuit, how this high pass circuit will alter the ramp signal, that is what we need to see in this particular video. Okay, so let us start with the mathematical analysis. So before I start with the mathematical analysis, remember this. The waveform which is equal to 0 for t less than 0, and the waveform which will assume the linear value called as alpha t for t greater than 0 is called as a ramp signal. Now here the slope of the waveform is alpha. Okay, the input waveform can be expressed as Vi of t is equal to alpha t for t greater than 0. That is what we have written here. Okay, now remember this, the Laplace transform of this particular waveform is Vi of s, and it is given by alpha by s square. Why? Because the Laplace of t is nothing but it is 1 by s square. So alpha t, so alpha multiplied by 1 by s square. So alpha by s square is the Laplace of this particular signal. Now you know the transfer function of high pass circuit, and if I multiply the transfer function with the input applied, I can get the output waveform, so that we can sketch it. So let us try to find the output waveform so that I can calculate its value mathematically, and then we will be sketching it from that particular expression. Okay, so let us start with this. So transfer function of high pass circuit is given by H of s is equal to 1 upon 1 plus 1 by RCS, and therefore V0 of s means the output waveform will be the transfer function H of s multiplied by Vi of s. So it is 1 upon 1 plus 1 upon RCS multiplied by alpha upon s square. Why? Because Vi of s is alpha by s square. Okay. Now just see how we can manipulate this particular equation. So let us multiply numerator and denominator. So multiply numerator and denominator by RC. So what will happen here? So your V0 of S will be RC upon RC plus 1 by s here, RC upon RC plus RC, so RC RC will be cancelled, so it will be 1 by s multiplied by alpha by s square. Okay, so we can write it as alpha RC Okay, now if I multiply this, what will be there? So I can write it here. So S can be taken common. So I can write it 1 plus RCS. So if I multiply this, I am taking S common. So I will be taking alpha RC upon S plus 1 plus S alpha RC upon S in the bracket 1 plus RCS. Okay. But this term, now if I want to solve, I can solve it by partial fraction. So now it will require the knowledge of partial fraction for solving this expression. Now if I compare it with the equation, so I can write V0 of S is equal to C A by S, so C A upon this S plus B upon the second term that is remaining, and the second term is 1 plus RCS. So now I can calculate the values of A and B from partial fraction method. So let us now come here. We'll of course try to solve it here. We'll solve it here. So now we have the equation, this A upon S plus B upon, so for A, so we'll be calculating the value of A first. So for A, now if I want to calculate the value of A, so A is equal to the second value, this one. So it is 1 upon 1 plus RCS, and we need to put S is equal to 0 so that I can get the value of A. So A comes out to be 1. See, 1 upon 1 plus S is 0, so this term becomes 0, so A becomes 1. Now similarly, B is equal to what? It is 1 upon S, and now put the value of S to be minus 1 by RC, and therefore B comes out to be minus RC. Therefore B comes out to be minus RC. Now let us put it in this equation, the equation that we have for V0 of S. So V0 of S, now it will be, see, alpha RC in the bracket, see, alpha RC in the bracket, 1 by S A minus, so now I will put the value of B. So what is the value of B? It is minus RC upon 1 plus RCS. Okay, see what I have done is I have just put the value, see, alpha RC as it is, so A upon S plus B upon 1 plus RC. See this, A, I put the value of A here, I put the value of B here, and alpha RC was the thing that was there in the upper part, so I have taken it as it is. Okay, now if I multiply this in the bracket, if I multiply this in this bracket, so what will be there? Alpha RC upon S minus alpha RC upon S plus 1 by RC. See this, alpha RC upon S, this is very easy to understand. See, alpha RC will become here alpha R square C square, so that will be cancelled with that, and I can take RC common, so RC will be cancelled, so it will be alpha RC upon S plus 1 by RC. So now taking inverse Laplace transform, so taking inverse Laplace transform, we will be having V0 of t, because I want the equation to be in terms of V0 of t so that I can sketch it back. So it will come out to be, see, alpha RC as it is, 1 by S is 1, okay, and minus, what will be there, alpha, okay, so alpha into e to the power minus t by RC. See, S plus 1 by RC is nothing but it is e to the power t minus RC. So it is alpha RC into e to the power t minus RC. What I will be doing is, let us have alpha RC common. So alpha RC, if I am taking it common, it will be 1 minus e to the power minus t by RC. So your V0 of t comes out to be alpha RC in the bracket 1 minus e to the power minus t by RC. Simple, alpha RC as it is, 1 by S is 1, and then alpha RC as it is, and this term is nothing but it is e to the power minus t by RC that we have seen in the step input. Okay, so from there we have calculated now the output voltage that we will be getting. Now let us sketch it, the output waveform. So I will be sketching it here. See, here there are two conditions that we can consider here. One is where RC is quite less than capital T. So what will happen? See this. So V0 of T versus T, and I am sketching the input waveform. Let us say alpha T. Now what will happen? The input will follow the output till a certain point, and then it is going to decay or fall down exponentially. Why? Because you have this term c e to the power minus t by rc, so it is going to exponentially come down. So it is going to follow the input for a certain period. It is going to follow the input for a certain period like this, which I will make it dark, and then it is going to fall. Now this difference between input and output is termed by a new concept called as transmission error, ET, transmission error. Okay, because we want the output to follow the input, but the output is not following the input, but it is dying down. See, by this particular expression, the exponential expression, and that's why you can find that the output is going to be going down from here, and that difference between the input and the output is called as the transmission error. So what is the expression for this? So it is the expression for output waveform is this, 1 minus e to the power minus t by rc, and the difference between this is t. Now remember this, if you have the second condition where rc is quite greater than capital T, now what will happen? This t is going to be very less as compared to the RC time constant, and that will reduce the transmission error. So transmission error will be very less in this. So this is alpha T and this is your V0 of T. So remember this, here the transmission error is going to be more when RC is quite greater than T, and the transmission error for RC quite greater than capital T, it is going to be quite less. So the transmission error can be reduced if you design the circuit in such a way that the value of RC is quite greater than capital T. Remember this. Okay. Now the important thing you need to know in this thing is you need to find the expression for the transmission error. That is the question which is asked in the examination. So let us have the expression for transmission error. So let us start with this expression for transmission error. Remember the numericals are asked, or this expression is also asked, so it is very important. So expression for transmission error, or ET I can say. So let us try to find it out. So for that purpose, let us define it first. So we will take the definition of the transmission error first, and then we will be calculating the value of transmission error. So when a ramp signal is transmitted, remember, through the linear network, the output departs from the input. That is what we have seen. So if I want to draw it like this, so this is your V0 of T, and this is your T, and this is your input waveform. So of course the output follows the input and then it departs. So this departure is nothing but it is called as ET. Remember this. Now so what we were defining is when the ramp signal is transmitted through a linear network, that is high pass circuit, the output departs from the input, and the measure of this departure is called as transmission error. And that can be calculated by the formula, or by taking the difference between the input and the output waveforms. So I can mathematically define it as ET is equal to, remember, ET is equal to VI minus V0 upon VI. This is how it is defined, the transmission error. Now by this we need to put the values, and then we need to try to find the expression for the transmission error. So let us go for that. So you know that VI is alpha T, and what is V0? V0 is alpha RC in the bracket 1 minus e to the power minus T by RC. This is what we have calculated, and divided by again the input waveform. So input waveform is alpha T. Now we need to solve it. Let us solve that. Okay. Now what will happen is, at let us say the time instant small t is equal to capital T. Now the expression is going to be ET is equal to alpha capital T minus alpha RC into 1 minus e to the power minus T by RC. So I am taking a time instance, let us say, which is equal to capital T. So this is the expression is going to be changed into now capital T terms. Okay, now I'm going to solve this. So for that purpose, what I'm doing is I will be just calculating the value of V0. I have put it here, but let me calculate or simplify this equation called as V0, and then I will be coming back to this equation. So I'm putting this as equation number 1, and now I will be calculating the output waveform. So output voltage V0 of t is what? It is alpha RC in the bracket 1 minus e to the power minus t by RC. This is the term of output voltage. I will come back to this equation. Remember, I am taking now the output voltage so that I can simplify this part, and then I will put it here. Okay, see what will happen here. Now your expression has this term, which is 1 minus e to the power minus x, right? So I can take this term e to the power minus x. Now e to the power minus x means this particular term, where x is minus t by RC. So this term can be expanded. It is a kind of series that can be expanded, exponential series, and that can be expanded as 1 plus minus x upon 1 factorial plus minus x square upon 2 factorial plus and so on. So if I take only two terms, means square terms, still stay square terms if I am taking and neglecting the upper terms, what will be there? So e to the power minus x can be written as 1 plus, see what will be happening, minus t by 1 t by RC upon 1 factorial plus minus t by RC square upon 2 factorial. Okay, so that can be written as 1 minus t by RC plus t square upon twice RC whole square. Okay, now I can put this here. So now if I neglect the terms above square terms, so now I can write at alpha RC in the bracket 1, see this one as it is, minus, now I need to put it there, 1 minus t by RC plus t square upon twice RC whole square, and then bracket is going to be completed. Okay, now this 1 and this minus 1 get cancelled, so it is alpha RC in the bracket, what will be the term? Now the term is going to be, see, the term is going to be t upon RC plus t square upon 2 into RC square. Let us multiply alpha RC in the bracket, what will happen, see. So it will be alpha RC into t upon RC plus alpha RC into t square upon t into RC square. So this square term cancels with RC, and this RC cancels with this. So it is going to be alpha t plus alpha t square upon twice RC. Okay, I can take alpha t common, so it is going to be 1 plus alpha t upon twice RC. So alpha t common, so it is going to be 1 plus t upon okay, remember this one mistake we have made, so that is very important to understand. Here if I multiply this, so this will become plus and this term will become minus. So this is going to be minus. So everything that we have done, so I just replace it by the minus sign. So it is alpha t in the bracket 1 minus alpha t upon twice RC. Okay, now, so this is the term for the output waveform. So output waveform is nothing but it is V0 of t is equal to alpha capital T 1 minus alpha capital T upon twice RC. Now let us put this in the expression number 1 that we have taken, this expression number 1 of transmission error. Okay, so let us take the next slide. So I will just keep it here so that you can understand. So let us solve it for transmission error now. So transmission error ET is VI minus V0 upon VI. Let us put it value alpha t minus, now we have got this expression, what is that? That is alpha t in the bracket 1 minus alpha t upon twice RC divided by alpha t. This expression I have put it here. Okay. Now let us try to solve it. So what will be the next term? See this. What will be the next term? So next term is going to be, okay, so let us divide this. So alpha t upon alpha t is going to be 1 minus, Let us multiply this. So it is alpha t. Okay. Or I can take alpha t common. So alpha t common can give me the value, right? So if I take alpha t common, see what will happen. In this term, if I take alpha t common, so alpha t common, so it is going to be 1 minus 1 plus, now minus minus becomes plus, upon, it is going to be t by twice rc, right? Okay, so that is going to be cancelled now upon alpha t, of course. So this alpha t and this alpha t is going to be cancelled, so the term will become only t by twice rc. So the expression for et we have calculated as capital T by twice rc. But remember one thing, you have the lower cutoff frequency because it is a high pass filter, so you have lower cutoff frequency, or it is also called as 3 dB frequency, F1. So F1 is 1 upon 2 pi RC. Therefore, I can have the value of twice RC from here. So twice RC is equal to what? It is 1 upon, what is that? That is 1 upon pi F1. Now I can put it here. So ET will become T multiplied by pi F1, and therefore I can say it is equal to pi F1 upon F. So it comes out to be pi F1 upon F. Why? Because capital T is nothing but it is 1 upon F, frequency, the inverse of frequency. So here see this, the transmission error comes out to be pi multiplied by the lower cutoff frequency or 3 dB frequency and divided by the frequency of the signal that you have applied. So by this you can calculate the transmission error. Now remember this, this is very important expression as far as the examination is concerned. Plus for the numericals also you will need this expression. So prepare this expression nicely because it is very important. Okay. Now this is what is the last signal that we have applied. But see, remember friends, we are continuously talking about high pass circuit as differentiator. Okay, so let us prove it, how the high pass circuit acts as differentiator. So this is our next part. So we'll write high pass circuit as differentiator. Now how this is operating or how the circuit acts as differentiator, that is what we need to see. So of course I will be drawing the circuit that we are considering right from the beginning. So this is your V0, this is resistance, this is capacitance, and this is your input voltage, and let us say the current flowing through here, it is I, capital I am considering. The current flowing through the circuit is capital I. Now remember, if the circuit of this figure is designed in such a way that your time constant RC is very small as compared to the time period of the waveform, means RC is quite small as compared to capital T, then only the high pass circuit acts as differentiator. So this is very important thing to know, that when this high pass circuit is going to be acting as differentiator, the only thing is the value of RC, it should be quite less than capital T, the time period of the waveform that you are applying. Okay, so by this assumption that the value of RC is quite less than capital T, now we will be proving that the high pass circuit is nothing but it acts as the differentiator. Okay, now see this, what will happen is, assuming at small t is equal to 0, the capacitance voltage is going to be 0. Okay, you know that if I apply the KVL in this particular loop, so Vi is going to be Vc plus Vr. The voltage will be dropped across capacitance and it will be dropped across resistance. The voltage across resistance and the output voltage is same. So Vr and V0 is same. So I can write Vi is equal to Vc plus V0, or I can write Vi is equal to Vc plus IR. V0 is current multiplied by resistance, so IR, the voltage is IR. Okay, now if I let us say The equation here, if I write for the capacitance, so it is going to be 1 by C. So I can calculate by this expression, I can calculate the voltage across capacitance. So it is going to be the current equation 1 upon C integration of IDT plus IR. Now if I consider one complete cycle has been completed, so now small t is equal to capital T. Let us say that one complete cycle has been completed, and at that point what will happen, and then what I will be doing is and multiplying both sides by C means to this equation. So I will be getting Vi into C is equal to integration of 0 to capital T C. 1 by C and C will be cancelled out, IDT plus IRC. Again, I have multiplied C to both the sides and I have taken the integration from 0 to T because I have now assumed that one complete cycle has been passed. But see here, we have assumed here RC is quite less than capital T, and therefore this term IRC, it is going to be quite less than capital T, and therefore I can neglect this term over the integration. Okay, and therefore I will say neglecting IRC over integration of 0 to T of IDT. And therefore what will be the term? The term will be VIC is equal to integration of 0 to capital T of IDT. Okay, now let us differentiate this. So differentiating equation with respect to time. So what we will have? Will have C into dVi by dt equals to I. Remember this. Okay, just I will be writing it here. So remember this, C dVi by dt into I. But see here, if I take output voltage V0 is nothing but it is IR. It is IR, and therefore I is equal to what? It is V0 by R. So from here I can put the value of I to be V0 by R in this equation. So let us say this was equation number 1. So putting I is equal to V0 by R in equation 2. See what will happen. So equation will become C dVi by dt is equal to V0 by R. And therefore I can say V0 is equal to RC into dVi by dt. So you can see this from the expression that the output is the differentiation of input waveform if RC is constant, and of course RC is constant, they are called as RC time constant. But remember this, RC should be quite less than capital T, then only your circuit is going to act as a differentiator. So in this way you can prove it that the RC high pass circuit acts as a differentiator because the output voltage is the differentiation of the input voltage if the RC time constant is kept constant. Okay, now let us take two numericals based on this, very important two numericals that we will be considering. One we will be taking of course of a square wave, and another I will be talking about the ramp signal that we have seen today. So let us talk about the numerical. So I am considering a numerical, I will write it here, a square wave shown is applied to RC differentiator with RC is equal to 0.2 second. Okay, sketch the output waveform and prove that area under positive section is equal to area under negative section. This is what is asked. So a good numerical, and see what is given. The square wave is given. So I will write this is Vi of t 0, this is t, and the square wave is given like this. See here what is there, 0.1 s, and this is given to be 0.2 seconds. Interesting, see, it is not symmetrical. See, it is 0.1, they are talking about square wave, but the time period is given to be 0.1 second and 0.2 seconds, so it is very different. Okay, and then let us talk about the term. Here it is 0.5 volts and it is minus 0.5 volts. Okay, so it is 1 volt peak to peak. And okay, this is what is given, and you need to find, or you need to sketch the output waveform and then prove that the area under the output curve in positive section is equal to the area under negative. So the numerical is very important. Many times it is asked for eight marks in the university examination. So let us try to find it. So what I will be doing is the knowledge that we have. So I know the output is going to be, see this, if I consider this to be V1, from V1 it is going to fall to V1 dash, from V1 dash it will go to somewhere V2, and from V2 it is going to come back to V2 dash, and from V2 dash it is going to be equal to V1. Okay, so I need to find the four values, V1, V1 dash, V2 and V2 dash, so that I can sketch the output waveform. Okay, this is what is my consideration to understand the numerical. The red colored sketch is representing your output waveform, so we need to sketch that actually. Okay, so let's start with this. So here what is given parts, I will write RC is given 0.2 seconds, so time constant RC is given 0.2 seconds, T1 is 0.1 second, and remember T2 is 0.2 seconds. Okay, so let us start with V1 dash. So we'll write, we know that because we have already seen that. So we know that V1 dash is equal to, means this. So its initial value is V1. So it is V1 into e to the power minus T1 by RC, because we are calculating it at T1. This is T1, this is T2. So at T1 I am calculating. So I'll write it here like this. Okay, and therefore V1 comes out to be V1 is equal to e to the power minus 0.1 divided by 0.2, because T1 is 0.1 second and RC is 0.2 second. So now V1 dash comes out to be V1 into 0.6065. So let me talk about equation number. Or I will write it like this, so it will be very simple, 0.6065 V1. So let me talk about equation number 1. Okay. Because we don't know the value of V1, that's why. Okay. Now let us calculate the second value. Similarly, what will be V2 dash? V2 dash will be V2 into e to the power minus T2 by RC. So V2 into e to the power minus 0.2 divided by 0.2. So it comes out to be, V2 dash comes out to be 0.3678 times V2. Let me talk about equation number 2. So I have calculated the value of V1 dash and V2 dash in terms of V1 and V2, because we don't know the values of V1 and V2. So we need to find it. Okay. Okay. So these are two equations. Okay. So let me solve it again at this point. So now let me talk about at small t is equal to capital T1, what will happen, means at this point I am talking about. Okay, so the output is here, capital V, because this entire voltage is capital V. So at this point the output is V1 dash minus V2, V1 dash minus V2, V1 dash minus V2. Okay, so that is okay, but what is V? The complete voltage, the peak to peak voltage, that is this one, is nothing but it is 1 volt. So V is equal to 1 volt, that I know. So I can put it here, 1 is equal to V1 dash minus V2, and therefore I can say V2 is equal to V1 dash minus 1. So let me talk about equation number 3. This I will mark it, okay, so that we can understand. This is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. this is equation number 3. Similarly, at small t is equal to t2, what is the output? Small t is equal to t2, output is v is equal to v1 minus v2 dash. See, v1 minus v2 dash, because it is a negative sector. Okay, so again it is 1 is equal to v1 minus v2 dash. So what is v1? So v1 is 1 plus v2 dash. Let us talk about equation number 4. Okay, now what I will be doing is I will put, I'm just writing it here now. So put equation number 4, this v1, in equation number 1. Because this is v1 was missing here, no? So I'm putting it here. So what will be there? So v1 dash is going to be 0.6065 multiplied by 1 plus v2 dash. So it is going to be 0.6065 plus 0.6065 v2 dash. Let me talk about this equation to be equation number 5. Okay, now put equation number 3 in equation number 2. Why? Because equation number 3 is having the value of v2, and here we have the value of v2. So what will be the equation then? The equation will be v2 dash is equal to 0.3678 multiplied by this value v1 dash minus 1. So it is 0.3678 v1 dash minus 0.3678. So let me talk about equation number 6. I hope this till this part it is clear. Okay, let us solve it here. So now what I will be doing is I will be simultaneously solving equation number 5 and 6, because these terms are similar. See here, equation number 5 has the term of v2 dash, and here it is v1 dash. So v1 and v2 are the two variables for which we are solving the simultaneous equation. So solving equation 5 and 6 simultaneously, you can directly calculate it by the calculator also, no problem in that. So from that, if I calculate by calculator, so here we will get the value of v1 dash to be 0.4935 volts and v2 dash to be minus 0.1863 volts. V1 dash comes out to be 0.4935 volts and v2 dash comes out to be minus 0.1863. Now you will say, sir, it should be symmetrical, but why it is not? Because your time period is changed. See, time period t1 is 0.1 and time period t2 is 0.2. And that's why you will find the difference in the pump voltages. So v1 dash and v2 dash, two values we have calculated. Okay, then therefore from equation number 4, see the equation number 4, you know the value of now the value you can be put. So v2 dash we can put this value and we can calculate the value of v1. So what will happen? So from equation number 4, we have v1 is equal to 1 minus 0.1863. And therefore V1 comes out to be 0.8137 volts. Similarly, from equation number 3, what will be the value of V2? So V2 will be 0.4935 minus 1. So it comes out to be 0.5065 volts. So we have calculated the values. All the four values have been calculated. So let us sketch the output waveform now. So now it is the turn to sketch the output waveform. So for that purpose, what I will be doing is, first of all, I will be writing the values v1, v2, v1 dash, v2 dash, and then I will be sketching it. So remember this, it is v1. So what is v1? So v1 is 0.8137 volts. V2 is minus 0.5065 volts. V1 dash is 0.4935 volts, and V2 dash comes out to be minus 0.1862 volts. So this is the voltage that we have calculated. Okay, now so see this, I will sketch it out. This is your V0 of t, this is 0 and t. Okay, so let me draw the dotted lines. the input waveform. Now the input voltage was 0.5 and here 0.5, remember. But the output is coming out to be greater than the input voltage. Why it is happening? Because capacitor stores the charges and it gives it at the output, so that output comes out to be more than the input, which is called as overshoot. That is called as overshoot. So let us mark V1. So V1 is somewhere here. It is 0.8137. So I am marking it here. So let me call it as V1. From V1 it will come out to be 0.4. So nearly equal to the 0.5 mark. So I will write V1 dash. From there it will go to V2 dash. So V2 dash will be very early, 0.18 only. And from there it will go to, okay, it will go to V2 first. So it will, V2 is 0.5, so it, somewhere it, here it will come, not V2 dash. V2 dash will be here somewhere, V2 dash, and again it will come to V1. So see, the output is going to be like this. This is going to be the output waveform from the real values. Okay. Now there was a second part. This was the first part of the numerical. The second part of the numerical is very interesting. The second part is you need to prove that the area under positive section is equal to the area under negative section. So let us shade that area. So A1 is the area under positive section, and let us say this is area 2. Where A2 is the area under negative section, and this is what we need to prove, that area under positive section is equal to area under negative section. Now let us find the area under the positive section first. So area under positive section can be calculated, of course, by the integration of all the points. So A will be integration of 0 to T1 of V1 dash dt, simple. That is under root of the integration of 0 to t1 of v1 into e to the power minus t1 by rc into dt. I have put the values. So v1 can be taken out, so it is 0.8137 integration of 0 to 0.1, because t1 is 0.1 now, into e to the power minus t1 by rc into dt, capital t1 into, okay, 0.8137 integration of, okay, now I'm just solving it, e to the power minus t by rc upon minus 1 by rc, and of course the limit 0 to 0.1, so 0.8137 multiplied by rc will be out because it is constant. And now I have put the equation, e to the power minus 0.1 divided by rc minus e to the power 0, putting the limits, and therefore I will get it 0.8137 multiplied by, the value of RC is given to be 0.2, okay, and therefore e to the power minus 0.1 upon 0.2 in minus e to the power 0, that is 1, okay. So it value comes out to be, A1 comes out to be 0.0640 square units. Why I am writing square units? Because I don't know the exact unit of that, and the area is again in the square. So 0.064 is the area under positive curve. So if my area comes out to be similar in the negative section, then only I can prove it. So let us talk about, this is equation number one, and now I will be calculating the area under negative curve. So area under negative section A2 is equal to 0 to T2. Remember, 0 to T2, not T1 to T2, V2 dash into dt. Consider it from beginning. So now it is 0 to T2 of V2 into e to the power minus T2 by RC into dt. Okay, then V2 will be outside the curve, 0 to 0.2 e to the power minus T2 by RC into dt. Okay, so it is minus 0.5065, which is outside the curve, and then I will be having the equation, e to the power minus t by rc upon minus 1 by rc, and then 0 to 0.2 Okay, then minus 0.5065 multiplied by putting the limits or multiplied by RC. I will be taking it first and then putting the limits. So it is the power minus 0.2 upon 0.2 C to the power 0. So it is going to be minus 0.5065 multiplied by 0.2. And here the term is going to be e to the power minus 0.2 upon minus 0.2 minus 1. Okay, and therefore your A2 comes out to be minus 0.0640 square units. So you can find that the value of A1 and A2, they are coming out to be same, but the only difference is there in sign, because one is the area for the positive section and another is the area for the negative section. And hence by equation number 1 and 2, we can show that the area under positive section is equal to the area under negative section. Remember, this numerical is very, very important. Okay, let us take another numerical based on the ramp signal. If ramp signal is applied to high pass circuit, the numerical is based on that. So let me talk about the second one. A limited ramp signal, a limited ramp signal is shown in the figure, is applied to high pass circuit. Draw the output waveform for three conditions are there. T is equal to 0.2 RC. Second one is capital T is equal to RC, and the third one is capital T is equal to 5 RC. This is what we need to find. Remember this. This is the numerical which is given. Okay, and the diagram is given like this. So this is the input waveform which is given. Just I will draw it. So it is Vi of T. Okay. This is the voltage V, and the given the slope of the curve is given to be V by T, and you need to calculate the value for the three conditions, when T is equal to 0.2 RC, when T is equal to RC, and when T is equal to 5 RC. So let us start with the first case. So before that, I will write the output of ramp signal applied to high pass circuit is given by V0 of T is equal to, if you remember, it is alpha RC in the bracket 1 minus e to the power minus T by RC. Okay, now let us talk about case number 1. So case 1, when T is equal to 0.2 RC, so equation 1 will become V0 of T is equal to, let us put it here. So before that, just write it here. So I can say RC is equal to T upon 0.2. okay, and the value of alpha is V by T. So let us put it at V0 of T is equal to, then what will happen? So alpha is V by T. RC is what? RC is capital T by 0.2. see, I am putting it here. Alpha is V by T, RC is T by 0.2 in the bracket 1 minus e to the power minus T. So minus T is 0.2 RC upon RC. Thus I have put this value. So now V0 comes out to be 0.9063 times V. So my equation is in terms of V. Remember, it is not in terms of any value, but in terms of V. It is not voltage, but it's V, value V. Okay, so this is your first output. Now let us say case 2, where capital T is equal to what? Is RC. So if capital T is RC, and your alpha is V by T, so now equation 1 becomes, not this equation, the equation 1 that we have written, this becomes V0 of टी इज इक्वल टू अल्फा. व्हाट इज अल्फा? वी बाय टी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय आर सी. सो आर सी इज कैपिटल टी ओनली दैट आई हैव पुट मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1 माइनस ई टू द पावर माइनस आर सी अपॉन आर सी, बिकॉज नाउ टाइम कॉन्स्टेंट टी इज इक्वल टू आर सी. सो दिस टी टी गेट्स कैंसल एंड यू विल गेट द आंसर टू बी 0. सो वी जीरो ऑफ टी आई एम राइटिंग 0.6321. This is the second output that you will get, case 2. Now remember case 3, where what is there? Capital T is equal to 0.5 times RC. So of course RC is T by 0.5 and alpha is V by capital T. So equation 1 will become V0 of T is equal to alpha. So V by capital T RC T upon 0.5 into 1 minus e to the power minus what is T by RC, no? So T, what is T? 0.5 RC upon RC. The term will be there. And therefore, this is going to be cancelled and therefore your V0 of T comes out to be 0.1986V. So I have calculated this, but we need to sketch it. I have calculated all the three, but we need to sketch it. So how to sketch that? Remember, so what I will be doing is I will be just sketching it out here. Remember V0 of T is capital T. Now somewhere here I am getting V, right? So I will be taking my output till V. Okay. And then so this is your V level. Okay. Now the first output is 0.9063, means 90% of V. So somewhere here it will come. So I will be just sketching it. So here. So we'll write 0.9063V, 90% of the V. So what I will be doing is I will be sketching the output till that, just following it, and then from there it will decay. It will fall down. Okay. Now what is, so I will write it here. The condition is capital T is equal to 0.2RC. Now what is the second one? The second one is when T is equal to RC, and the answer comes out to be 0.63, so 60% of this somewhere here. So just put 0.6321V. So output will be following input till that point, and from there it will fall down. It will fall down. And the last one is 20%, that is 0.91986. So nearly 20%, 0.1986V. So the input will be following the output till that point, and from there it is going to fall down. So this is how the output waveform can be sketched. Till that point the input will follow the output linearly, and after that exponential decay will occur, because in your output term it, the term is there 1 minus e to the power minus t by RC. So you can see from these three points the output is decaying towards the x-axis, or is falling towards the x-axis. Okay, so these were the two numericals which are very important that we have considered. So now this is the end of high pass circuit. Remember we have taken five inputs. First was sinusoidal wave, second was step, then third was pulse, the fourth one was a square wave. Then in the square wave we have taken the expression for percentage tilt, then we taken a ramp signal, and in the ramp signal we have derived one important expression for transmission error. Then we have seen that why high pass circuit is called as a differentiator, and then we have taken the numericals based on this. So seven things we have covered in these three videos of linear wave shaping. In the next video we will be starting with the low pass circuit. Remember the low pass circuit. Okay, thank you. Till then, take care of yourself.